In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of piriformis. This muscle is located very deep part of hip joint. By the way, this is posterior part of hip joint. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function and important anatomical connection with nervous tissue and internal organ. So, where is piriformis from? It's from sacrum. Okay, it's from sacrum. When you look anatomy book, it looks like piriformis originates from lateral part of sacrum. But is that true? It's not. Actually, piriformis originates from anterior part of sacrum. Okay, this is anterior view. This is piriformis. It originates from anterior surface of sacrum. Let's go back to first picture. See? From posterior view, piriformis is from, you know, lateral part, but it's not. It's from anterior part. Anterior part of sacrum. Okay, this is very, very important. So I'm going to explain the relationship with internal organ later. Okay, this is origin. Okay, insertion is this part. This is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. This is very, very big bony bump. By the way, there are many other muscles attaching on greater trochanter, such as gluteus medius. Gluteus medius, gluteus minimus, and deep lateral rotators. Lateral rotators. That means when piriformis gets tight, this tightness can affect other deep rotators or gluteus medius or gluteus minimus. This is very busy, compacted area. Okay? Origin of piriformis is anterior part of sacrum. Insertion is greater trochanter. Now, let me explain its function. Function of piriformis is what? External rotation. External rotation or lateral rotation. Okay, this way. Plus, it can do abduction. Abduction of hip joint. Abduction is this way, right? External rotation, abduction plus extension. Okay, piriformis has so many things to do. External rotation, abduction, extension. And it has something to do with stabilization for hip joint. Why? Because when muscle is located deeper and deeper and deeper, it has something to do with stabilization. If muscle is on superficial part, it doesn't have something to do with stabilization a lot, okay? Of course, the superficial muscle can stabilize joint, but when you go deeper and deeper and deeper, this deep muscle has more important role for joint stabilization. Okay, this is very important. Piriformis, movement of hip joint plus stabilization. Oh, by the way, piriformis is only two hip joint muscles that originate from axial skeleton. Okay, sacrum is axial skeleton, right? What is the other muscle that originates from axial skeleton? That is psoas. Psoas is from lumbar spine. Then it attaches on femur. Okay. Piriformis from sacrum to femur. Other hip muscles originate from pelvis. That's why these two muscles have something to do with spine movement, right? That is why psoas and piriformis are very, very important. Now, let me explain relationship with nervous tissue. Okay, you see yellow tissues. These are nerves. One nerve which has very close relationship with piriformis is this one. This is sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve. This is the biggest peripheral nerve in human body. Usually, sciatic nerve shows up from inferior part of piriformis. Ah, that's very close. What happens when piriformis gets tight or shortened? Maybe that can compress sciatic nerve. What happens when sciatic nerve got impingement? That can create pain or numbness around gluteal area or posterior part of thigh. That is why piriformis has strong relationship with sciatic nerve. For some people, researchers say sciatic nerve penetrates piriformis. Okay, this is very common. Okay, sciatic nerve sometimes penetrates piriformis. So that sounds like tension of piriformis is very, very important if somebody's sciatic nerve penetrates piriformis. So flexibility of piriformis is very important for nervous tissue relationship. Okay, this is the famous relationship. Now, next part, I'm going to explain relationship with internal organs. As I said, origin of piriformis is anterior part of sacrum. What's there? What is in front of sacrum? There are many, many tissues, such as autonomic nervous system, like this. Okay, autonomic nervous system. Other nerves are from sacrum. Okay, plus there are internal organs, like rectum. Rectum is the final part of large intestine. Okay, then posterior to pubis, this is still anterior to sacrum, right? Posterior to pubis, there is bladder. For female, there is uterus. Pelvic space is very, very small, very narrow. It's very condensed area. Now, piriformis is from anterior part of sacrum. What happens when piriformis gets tight? Then there is still myofascial connection. That can aggravate fascia of autonomic nervous system, fascia of rectum, fascia of uterus and bladder. To be simple, piriformis has relationship with anterior part of sacrum. There is connection to internal organs, autonomic nervous system and peripheral nervous system. That is why this muscle is important for nervous tissue connection and internal organ connection. Not only the low back pain. Okay, in this video, I explained basic anatomy of piriformis. I explained its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical relationship. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.